So it looks like we got two girls, one lie, or two girls, one Titan, whatever you want to call it with this episode of Attack on Titan. So with that being said, I know some people are going to say, which to a certain degree, I can kind of understand that the first half of this episode was a bit slow because we was getting exposition and a buildup to the past and what led up to the point regarding not necessarily even with this reveal, but more so the characters Krista and Ymir, which to be fair, when we was coming into the season, if you've seen some of the interviews from the creators of Attack on Titan, you know, the studio, and in particular, you know, Hajime Isayama, the author of the manga, they said that this was pretty much going to be, at the very least, a good chunk of Attack on Titan season 2 about Ymir and Krista. They were going to be big key players, and this episode was just that. Now, I think maybe it took a bit more longer than it should have regarding getting this backstory of them, because essentially we started off with a flashback, and the flashback took place prior to any of this stuff. I believe even Marco was in there, so this was even prior to, like, you know, the beginning of season 1 of Attack on Titan. So we got a flashback to back then, but the meat of it all and the interesting thing was basically finding out a little more about Krista and Ymir. I feel as though with Krista, up until the very end of the episode, we got like inklings and little tiny bits about her. We definitely got more about Ymir in this episode, because Ymir, we find out, holy shit. I mean, in the last episode, we found that out, but this one dove a little more into her backstory. And, well, not necessarily even her backstory, just the fact that she's a damn Titan, like, holy shit. And it feels as though this episode was taking Yuri on Ice a little more literal than what the actual series did, because we had two girls, Yuri style, and they were on ice, literally. So yeah, we had that. And I mean, it's fine. I don't know. People might have a problem with it. I thought it was all right to see something a little bit different the way they did it. Now, again, going more so into the characters, their relationship and their bond and whatnot, it seems though, because Ymir seemingly had a hard life, because you see that she tried to make it sound a little bit nicer than it was. She was like, yeah, you know, I was trying to be in the church to borrow some stuff that I needed, some food or whatever, you know. She was basically robbing because she needed to eat, she needed to get other stuff, whatever. So you see Ymir kind of had it hard, and she overheard, which was kind of convenient, but nevertheless she overheard what was going on with Krista, although at the time she didn't really know it. And Ymir, you can see that she's pretty smart, because she was able to use psychology to get it out of Krista that, oh, you're that girl that they were talking about with the illegitimate father, or, you know, being the bastard child, so to speak. So it was diving a little more into that territory, where it was kind of like, again, felt a little convenient there, but nevertheless, we get inklings of Krista, because throughout this episode, some of the stuff that we got is, one, she's apparently from some sort of nobility or some sort of royalty, and she's like a bastard child that they kind of wanted to hide because she was an illegitimate child. So we know a little bit there's something funky going on with her backstory there. And also, she had to hide her name and her identity in order to survive, basically, because if not, they were going to kill her. It was like, either you fucking take a fake name and you piss off, or we're going to kill you, bitch. And she decided, okay, you know what, I'll just make a new life. So you're starting to understand a little bit more about Krista and who she really is, and seeing that maybe some of this was a facade of what she's been all along. And something that I wanted to note, because it seems as though in the flashback, Ymir said, I'm going to tell you my secret, right? I'm going to tell you what happened, because, you know, she was able, which was obvious in, you know, in the flashback, that she was able to get down the mountain, because she saw a strike of lightning, and then all of a sudden her and that dude that was dying is gone down the mountain or whatever. She was like, I'm going to tell you my secret, but I want you, when things get revealed, for you to accept your name and accept who you are, and, you know, just put it out there. So when they asked her, I believe it was Reiner and Bertolt and maybe even Connie, when they were like, did you know that she was a Titan? She said, no, I had no idea. Was she lying right there? Because it seems as though, again, in that flashback, Ymir was like, yeah, I'm gonna give you the goods. I'm gonna tell you my secret, which is, hey, I'm a fucking Titan. What do you know? So I was kind of curious about that, if Krista was just lying, or she didn't tell her at the time, and she meant, like, eventually I am going to tell you about my secret, and everything will come to light at the same time. the art and animation. I gotta stress, because some people, they might look at the scene and they see like Ymir's character design was a little simplified when she's moving, but the animation, my gosh, I ain't gonna lie. It feels as though with season 2 of Attack on Titan, even though, again, we're only getting 12 episodes, sad times, I know we wanted 25, what can we do? It's 12, it is what it is. Even though we're only getting that, the animation, the fluidity, when Ymir is just jumping all over the castle and shit like that, moving around, fighting the Titans, it looks gorgeous. And even the art, honestly, you can see, and this is from me watching anime for so many years, every few years I can look back and see, oh, anime has evolved even further. There's more techniques, there's more different styles that they can use that looks better than a few years ago. And I felt as though this episode in particular showed just that. The animation, the fluidity of it, but also the art and the colors, you know, this color scheme at that, it just really looked like, yeah, this is 4 years more of advancement in the anime industry, and it looked really fucking nice. So the Ymir scenes against the Titans, you cannot complain. That shit was amazing. It looked fucking hype as shit. But going more into her character, it seems as though you gotta compare Ymir at this point. She's more like an Annie and less like an Eren in regards to she knew she was a Titan when she went in and actually was saving them, but she knew. So maybe you could say she's a mixture. Maybe she's more like she knew she was a Titan like Annie, but maybe she's a good person like Eren. Or it could just be, again, the whole Yuri thing is like, I don't really give a fuck about the mother motherfuckers, but Krista, I want to get in your pants, so I'm gonna save you, all right? Is that fine? Can we do it like that? And I'm sure at that point, Reiner was like, I'm in the mood to fight a dyke or two. So yeah, the first half of the episode was a bit slower, but I felt as though what it was setting up and getting a little bit more of the insight into Ymir and Krista and finding out a little bit more about Krista and, you know, again, Ymir, it was fine. It wasn't the greatest thing in the world, but it was fine. Second half of the episode, that's when I was like, okay, then we're picking up some steam, because that's when we got, first of all, Mikasa showing up with Eren. First of all, let's talk about Mikasa. I was like, yes, because this season has been lacking on the epicness that is Mikasa. Let's be clear here, because season one, Mikasa sold season one. She was one of the big things that everybody was like, I love the yandere shit, I love how down she is for Eren. But she's also kicking ass. And when she came through in this scene and was chopping motherfuckers up and just looking badass, I was like, this is what we signed up for. This is that chick right there. So awesome shit there. And it was weird because you don't really think, especially because if you've seen Attack on Titan so many years ago, you kind of forget. Eren, as, you know, just in his normal self, not as a Titan, never really killed a Titan. So in this episode, he's like, oh, I finally got my first one, and then he trips and falls and fucks up, and it kind of reminds you that even though he has these Titan powers, he's still a klutz, he's still not the greatest when it comes to combat using the 3D maneuver gear, so it kind of brings us back to reality that, yeah, he never really did that much shit when he was normal before the Deus Ex Machina, yeah! But just seeing the brutality and carnage, like, that was some cool shit. Honestly, if we got the exposition and all the story building in the first half, then we got the goods that everybody else wants in the second half regarding just awesome action and animation and seeing the cadets finally showing up and doing some cool shit. Now the end of the episode, because a lot of people are gonna be like, so Ymir is dead? What's going on there? I mean, she was missing an arm. It looked like her intestines were all ripped out or some shit. But we've seen Eren come back from some shit. We've seen, as a Titan shifter, he's gotten fucking wrecked. And we've seen him get his ass kicked and he's come back. So I'm imagining, you know, looking at it from that angle, there is a possibility they're playing with us at that point. But then again, you never know. And because even though I've read the manga, I'd be very spoiler free, I'm not gonna tell you what actually is gonna happen. Hey. But a nice way to end the episode. And as a whole, this episode, I know some people are gonna complain about the first half, but you need, like, it's good storytelling. I don't know why people, like, they want the action so bad, and I love the action, all that stuff, but when you get the build-up to it, it makes it that much more interesting and more insightful and overall more worth it. So you needed that first half. Maybe, again, it could have been shaved off by a few minutes. We didn't need 12 or 13 minutes of this, you know, dyke love affair that was brewing in the wind. We could have had that chopped down by, like, about 5 minutes. Get 5 minutes of them being in the snow out of here, and it would have been golden. So, yeah, I still say it was a very solid episode. Building more into this character, Historia, finding out that name and her ties to things is going to make things more interesting. But I'm kind of curious what you guys thought about a couple of these events. What did you think about finding out more about Krista, her real name? What do you think this means for the Attack on Titan world, especially the fact that she's seemingly related to some sort of royalty or nobility? Also, what do you think about Ymir and her transformation? As far as comparing Ymir as a Titan to like the Armored Titan or the Colossal Titan or hell, even Eren or the female Titan, she looks more weak because, like, you know, she just kind of got bodied out there, and at the end it looks like she's fucking dead. So it's kind of like she looks more weak, but as far as like agility and being able to be mobile, that's a good thing. So like, even though she's not like the Armor that's gonna rush in on a motherfucker or the Colossal that's just gonna slam motherfuckers, she is pretty mobile. And I still stand by something that I said a while ago. I think as a Titan shifter, she's up there, because she might not be, you know, the biggest and the strongest, but that agility, that speed is something in a one-on-one combat when she doesn't have 1,000 Titans attacking her is a good thing. So kind of curious, what are your thoughts on Ymir's Titan transformation? And one more thing, I just gotta say, next week's episode, this is gonna be the big one where if you're a manga reader, you know, and if you haven't and you're an anime only, or just in general, I feel as though this is going to be the episode that makes or breaks Attack on Titan Season 2 as being just as hype and just as big as Season 1, because I'll never forget reading this portion in the manga and how I reacted and how amazing it was. And judging from the trailers we've gotten for Season 2 and the preview we got for next week's episode, strapping your booties, mate, because it's going to be lit. Yeah, I'm not going to spoil, but next week's episode is going to be amazing. You do not want to miss it. But this week's episode, I'm going to give it the 8.5. It could have been a little bit quicker in the beginning. We could have cut out a couple of minutes there. But as a whole, it was really nicely built, getting more mystery, and at the same time, cool-ass action with our baby Mikasa, and even Eren stumbling and bumbling to his first kill. But that's all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, drop me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and stalk my Facebook to get more when the video ends. I'm Fineb World, and as always, people, have an awesome day.